In this video, we're going to explain precision and recall. Let's look at precision. How long does it take you to get to the nearest shop? Maybe it takes about 10 minutes. But how long precisely? 9 minutes, 48.43 seconds. That is precise. How about recall? Can you name your school friends from when you was 10 years old? I can name about 6 from about 15. So I can recall 6 friends. How do we use that when we're comparing two files? When we've got texts, we want to know how similar they are. So we need some type of measurement. Guess a number from 1 to 12. There's a few numbers here. So make some guesses. 2, 8, 4, 9, 10, 1. There's some guesses. Let's have a look at the answers. 1, 7, 3, 4, 8, 11. How many correct? So 8, 4 and 1 were correct. So that's 3 out of 6. That's 50%. Guess a number between 1 to 12. Make some guesses. 12, 2, 8, 4, 3, 11, 7, 10, 9. 10 guesses. How many were correct? I have 12, 1, 3 and 5. So 2 correct. 2 out of 10. 20%. Not so good. So we had 3 out of 6. So 3 correct and 3 wrong guesses. We had second time we had 3 and 12. We had 2 correct but we had 8 wrong guesses. So what is precision? In this example, we have 3 out of 6, so the precision was 50%. The second example, we had 2 out of 10, the precision was 20%. Here's 5 targets. We're going to shoot at them. First one hits. No. Second. No. No. Hit. Hit. No. 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 So that was 4 out of 10 shots, so 40% precision. Is precision the same as accurate? The answer is no. Here we've got an example of some shots on targets. The shots in the second one, B, are very good. They're all in the middle, so they're accurate and they're precise. In the example in C, they're not in the middle, so they're not accurate. But they are precise, they are together. What is recall? How many can you remember? There's going to be 2 sets of scores of 10 students. So 5 students, then another 5 students. I'm going to show you them for a few seconds and see how many you can remember. So here we go. Ooh, not long. How many can you remember? Write down as many guesses as you like and then we'll check how many you got correct. So how many did you find and how many did you not find correct? So in this example we found 3 but we didn't find 7. So we can say that what we found and what we didn't find is going to be the total, which is 10. So we found 3 out of 10 is 30%. If we would have found 6, we would have found 60%. So this is recall. 3 out of 10 is 30%, 6 out of 10 is 60%. That's recall. In our example with the targets, we had 5 targets and we hit 4. So 4 out of 5 is 80% recall. Okay, let's look at precision and recall together. So how many not correct? Well, if we have 6 guesses and we found 3, we got 50% right. If we had 6 out of 6 guesses correct, you could say that's 100% correct. 6 correct and no wrong. So how many of them were good? Well, we had 6 guesses and they were all correct. So 6 out of 6 equals 100%. But we didn't find 4 others. So 6 scores were found from 10. So that's 6 out of 10, which is 60%. So we had 100% precision, but 60% recall. 6 correct, none wrong, but 4 were not found. So how can we use precision and recall? One way is to compare text. Here we want to see if the second file is similar to the first file. So how are these files similar? How similar is the second text to the first text? The first text, you can see on the right at the top, is the description from previous video. And the text below that is the description from a video, another video. So you want to see if the second one is similar to the first. So we can look for the common terms. So there's some words in here that are the same. So we can say that if the text has common words, it's probably more likely to be more similar. So we can have a look at the common words. So here we have the set of common words from each of the two texts, the two files. So we can list the common words, and we have 8 in this example. We have Python, database, twice, and databases, connects, using, SQLite, and how. So the first text had 20 words and there were 8 common words. So that's a recall of 40%. The second text had 21 words and there was 8 common words. So the precision, 8 out of 21, is 38%. Okay, let's look at some code. So we've opened files before, so here we're going to open the file called text1 that has the first text in. My text1 is just an empty string. Now we're going to open the file, we're going to open it as a handle, and we're going to use that handle to use a for loop for each line. We strip the line of the new line character, anything that we don't want, and we add that, each line, into the text. You can see we use .lower to make the text lowercase to make sure that all the text is in lowercase so we can compare it. And then we're going to split that text into a list called words1. So you can print that to check it. Again, we do exactly the same when we do this for the second text. So this code is exactly identical except for it's the second text, and now we put the text into my text2 and those words into words2. In this example, we're going to remove the stop words. Stop words are common words that there's no meaning to them, so they're not useful when we're going to compare two texts. So we're going to remove these stop words. So examples of stop words are a and an and the and this and to and that. So we loop through the list of words, and if they are not in the stop words, then we put them in a new list, and that new list is new words1. Print that to check it's okay. Yes, that works fine. We're going to do that with both texts, and now we have new words1 and new words2. We want to find the common words, so we can loop through the new words. And if they're in the second list of new words, then we can add them to common words. We can remove duplicates by making the list into a set and back into a list. That's what the first line with common words does. We can count them into common number by using the length of the list. And we can print that just to check it's correct. So now we have the amount of unique words that are in both files and those words. So let's have a look. So here we've got our common words from the first text and the second text, and you can see them to the side, we have 7 unique words. We have database in databases, so you could say they're the same word. So these are slight problems we always have, and we're not going to deal with that in this video. So the answer that we wanted is not 6, and it's not 7 either. So we had a list of 7 unique words. You could think it was 6 if you said databases and databases the same, but that's not the answer we want. Why not? Well, if we look at our lists again, Python happens twice in the first list, but we only want to count it once because it happens once in the second list. Same with SQLite and How. So they only occur once, that's fine. But if you have a look, we've got database, database and databases. So we want to count database twice because it occurs twice in both texts, even if we think of databases as a separate word. So our answer, what we want, is we want to know that there's 8 common words. So we have to deal with these multiple versions. In a lot of texts, we're going to have words that occur a lot of times. So we can't just count unique words. We want to know how many times they occur as well. So how are we going to do this in our code? So we can deal with these multiples by finding them, and then we take the ones that will occur more than once in both texts, and we're going to find out the lowest amount. So if we had a word that occurred 5 times in one text, 10 times in another, we can say that that occurred 5 times in both. Not 10 times, because it didn't occur 10 times in the first text. In our code here, we use collections. So from collections, we import the counter. So we count the words, and then once we look at the count, we can see if a word occurs more than once in count words 1 and more than once in count words 2. In red, you can see what we need to do. We need to find the lowest out of these two amounts and add that to the total number of common terms. So we do that by looking to see which one's the greatest. If count ones is greater, then we want to use count two. If not, we want count words one. So what we're saying here is whichever one is the lowest, we're going to take that figure. Now, once we add that to the common number, we're going to reduce that by 1. If the lowest amount is 2, it's already in the common number once already. So we can have common number equals common number plus lowest minus 1. So what that's doing is, in our example, we had databases occurred once and database occurred twice. So we needed to add another figure of an extra 1 onto our count from 7 to 8. So database occurred twice, the lowest amount was 2, 2 minus 1 is 1, so we added the 7 plus 1 equals 8. So we had 7 unique words, databases occurred twice, so we needed to add an extra 1 on, 2 minus 1. Hope you understand that. And what we're doing there is we're adding on the amount of a word that occurs more than once in both texts. You may need to go through the example and the code a few times to really understand that, but believe me, we do need to do it. So how do we calculate recall? Well, recall is the total number, a common number, total number of common words we got, which was 8, divided by the amount of words that are in the first text. That's the first text minus our stop words, which was 20. 8 divided by 20 equals 0.4. So that's our recall. Our precision is the amount of common terms, common words, divided by the length of the second text minus stop words. So there was 21 words in that text. So 8 divided by 21 is just about 0.38. So that's our precision. So that's how we work out our recall and precision. There are other problems that we need to deal with that we haven't covered. Things like punctuation, plurals, So car and cars, or database and databases, is that the same? The same meaning. So if you said thank you or thanks, that has the same meaning. So should we deal with that? What about phrases? Well, thank you and thanks are the same. So should we count them as the same? So there are many language issues that you might have to address if you want to do this correctly. But we're not going to cover all of them. That would make it a very long video. Okay, let's have a look at some terms. So we have recall. Recall is just how many are correct divided by the total of correct and not found. What we're looking at is how many we correctly find out of the ones that we were looking to find. Precision is how many we got correct against how many we got not correct plus correct, if you like. So correct plus wrong answers. So in total, how many guesses do we have and how many were correct? So that's precision and recall. Okay, if you like this video, please click like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. Thank you for watching.